It's Friday, the 25th of February, and I'm filming today's message to you from the George A. Park, just across the road from St. Columbus. And it really is quite a magnificent day. The sun is shining, there's a light breeze in the background, a buzz of activity from children, flies and birds. Some magnificent summer greens in the grass and the trees, so much that speaks of light and life, and in such contrast to the darkness and despair that has global attention at the moment as we turn our focus to the Ukraine and to Russia. This coming Sunday is Transfiguration Sunday, one where we would typically look at, amongst other things, the symbolism of light as Jesus shines radiant on the mount, and how light speaks to us of who God is, and God's glory is a way in which it is often described. And yet, in reading and preparing for this coming Sunday, I was struck by the God who dwells in dark places. And I'd invite you to reflect further on this with me as we unpack and reflect at greater depth on this coming Sunday. For now, please do join me, do join us as a church, as we remember all of those whose lives and livelihoods are presently in real threat. May God bless you wherever this may find you.